Can you like get, I don't know.
What, my hair?
Yeah.
No, I can't.
No, but maybe.
I'm Daniel Decay with.
Can you like.
I'm Daniel Decay with BangerTV. I'm here at the 70,000 Tons of Metal cruise where earlier today I spoke with Elina, the operatic frontwoman of Leaves Eyes. Elina, thank you so much for taking time out of your day to sit down with me.
My pleasure.
I really enjoyed your set today on the pool deck. It was my first time seeing you.
It was
very, very powerful. I enjoyed it a lot.
Cool, thanks.
I want to ask you, playing in a band that has so many nautical and Viking type themes, lyrically and musically, what is it like to play on an actual ship?
For me, it's always going on stage is a little bit like, I come from the classical background, so going on an opera stage or something, so it's you know, telling these stories of Vikings and everything.
Right.
And of course, now it fits perfectly because we're on the sea and yeah, it's perfect.
Standing on stage and feeling the boat rock.
True.
Having played so many different types of festivals and shows with the band, what makes the 70,000 Tons of Metal stand out?
I think it's always on a ship, you're monster fans, which is very nice. It's very a friendly atmosphere and you get to meet lots of new people and of course see other bands as well. It's very relaxed. Well, for us, for example, we have some stage props like Alex uses the Viking sword.
Right.
And here it's not allowed to have it, so we'd have to basically have it in the security for the whole time and they just bring it on stage like today on the pool deck and then they take it away again, so.
did they literally stand by the side of the stage and hand it to you
I
and take it
so,
away?
Yeah, I saw the guy bringing it today.
that's pretty crazy. I guess they don't want anybody getting drunk late at night and playing with it.
I mean, it's not sharp, but still I understand it's a real sword. So.
Right. I understand you come from classical training and it ran in your family. How did you end up getting into heavy music?
It was after I finished my degree in Finland, Helsinki, and I moved to London to study a bit more contemporary styles. And I just really loved rock, performing it, especially on stage.
Right.
But I kind of thought, oh, well, my voice is never going to work. So I started my own band started writing. I've always written music, but started writing for myself and a bit heavier style. Still have that band going as well. And that's how it went, how we crossed paths with Leaves Eyes and everything kind of evolved from that.
Right.
So, yeah.
So you got a degree and then went on to study further into contemporary.
Yes.
How much more was there to learn it? I understand you'd already been giving vocal coaching lessons and you still felt the need to learn more.
It's actually completely different vocal style.
Right.
So that's what I want. That's why I wanted to kind of broaden my knowledge in that style. Also noticed that it wasn't really for me. Unfortunately, it's I have to sing with my voice and that's it. But it was a very great year for in every way.
So you stuck with the classical thing in the end?
Well, I kind of sing with some kind of mixture now,
okay.
But I can still, I mean, yeah, I can do classical, of course, and some bits I do have to because it's so high.
Do you have, there's lots of heavy metal and classical music collaborations, some big, some small. Do you have a favorite a collaboration that you've heard?
I prefer when it's real orchestras, real instruments and stuff, which is sometimes difficult to make happen. So of course, I would say the first in this genre, probably Nightwish, kind of started the whole thing.
So Leaves Eyes often gets described as symphonic metal.
Mm-hmm.
This is a term that I find gets thrown around a lot to a lot of different sounds. As someone with such a strong classical background, can you tell me what the tag symphonic metal really means to you?
Well, for me, symphonic metal means that it has to have orchestras, choirs, those elements that makes it symphonic.
Right.
And of course, Leaves Eyes is very heavily towards folk influences as well. There's a lot more native instruments and very interesting sounds, I think, kind of more and more since King of Kings. It's not only only symphonic, but you know, it's great to have those resources to be able to use all these palettes and then use them sparingly, so it's not like all the songs sound the same.
So do you feel that Leaves' Eyes is much more than just a symphonic metal band? Would that
I would say so, because if you listen to some songs, it's there are symphonic elements, of course, in almost all of the songs, but you know, there's also ballad, and some are heavier, like Sign of the Dragon Head, the title track, heavier, punchier, and then there's very folky songs, so you know, it's a nice mixture.
In general, when there's a female front in a band, some terms can get thrown around, such as angelic or perhaps Beauty and the Beast. How do these kind of generalizations make you feel as a female singer?
Well, it depends if you're describing the voice or if you're describing the visual side.
Right.
Because, of course, I mean, it's the truth. The voice is probably angelic and also powerful. Beauty and the Beast, I guess that's the term of having the growls in the band, so...
Do you find that the term female fronted gets thrown around as if it's a genre?
Yeah, it does. I mean, that's a problem, of course. I think a while ago I compared it to football or soccer.
Okay.
Because in a way, like when it's very male-orientated sport or something, then people want some term to say, oh, it's women's football or women's this and this, so it's female fronted metal. Of course it doesn't define the genre of this arch enemy, completely different type to Nightwish so it shouldn't be used for the music, but I mean, I guess people, I don't see it only negative thing, but it can be a bit of a generalization sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes you'll end up with a bill on a show where it's all bands that have female lead singers. But the genre spans so wide, it's...
Exactly.
To me, it's a little bit of ignorance.
It is a little bit weird, yeah, sometimes.
As the newest member in the band, what are your ambitions and goals for the future? What would you like to see happen for Leaves' Eyes?
Well, I mean, for me, it was great to do this album. I think it'll be great to make more music, to especially have the music fit my voice specifically, because it's always nicer, of course, play live when you've been part of the process of making the songs and everything. We've already been to quite a lot of places, but there's still a lot of places to go, so it would be great to get to these places and meet new fans. And
of course, having not composed everything on the record you just played on, was there ever a point where you found that your style and the style of Leaves' Eyes really meshed? Is there a moment on that album where you feel it's a true representation of what the future albums will sound like when you do compose together?
Well, I mean, the backbone of the band has always been Choso and Alex, so they write the music, lyrics mainly. Of course, this time I came into the process and we had to change some of the melodies and keys and stuff to make it work for my range. And all the songs, I think, work very well with my voice, but maybe personally, I prefer the more punchy songs, like from King of Kings, one of my favorites, Edge of Steel, to play it live, and maybe on this record than Sign of the Dragon Head or something, where I can kind of bring the power of my voice to the music as well.
Well, I look forward to hearing lots more from you. Thank you so much
Thank
for
you
taking
very much.
The time.
My pleasure.